Be lookups. You love them, you hate them, or you just plain don't understand them. Luckily, we can do something about that last part. I'm Justin Thrash, and today I'll be showing you how to use Vlookups in Excel and Google Sheets. Like any other formula in Excel or Google Sheets, if you type into a cell equals Vlookup open parentheses, the system will tell you what the structure of the formula is. In this instance, it is equals Vlookup open parentheses, lookup value, table array, column index number, range lookup, close parentheses. Let's dig into this by using an example. Let's say I have a big old list of data with ID numbers in my first column and a bunch of other info in the columns to the right. I have this smaller list of ID numbers and I want to use Vlookup to find their corresponding emails. So I'll go to an empty cell and start my Vlookup formula. Now the first entry the formula asks for is lookup value, which means what are you looking for in this specific example? We are looking up the ID number so we can type in the relevant cell or even just click on it. Next, we have table array. This is just asking you, where am I looking? Here you'll type in the range of cells that you want the system to look for, or you can just click and drag to select what you need. Third, we have index number. This is where the vertical and vertical lookup comes into play. This asks, what column should I return output from? So to get this number, we'll start counting the columns from within our table array, starting with the column where we have our lookup value, 1, 2, 3. So since what we're looking for is here in this third column, we'll put the number 3 as our index number. Lastly, the range lookup can either be true or false. If you type in true, then the system will look for not only your lookup value, but also approximations that are similar to it. 99% of the time, you'll want to use false for this. Then we hit enter and voila, we did it. We can even drag this formula down so it will reapply the Vlookup to any other IDs we want to look up. A few things to note. If you were paying attention, you probably noticed the user interface changing here and there. That's because I did this process in both Excel and Google Sheets and it functioned identically. Vlookup will look for the first item that matches your criteria, so if there are repeats in your data, it will only return the first instance. If you have repeats, you're probably going to have better luck using a different method, like a pivot table. Your index number must be to the right of your Vlookup value. It cannot be above or below, because then you need to use HLOOKUP, which stands for, I'm sure you guessed, horizontal lookup. It also cannot be to the left of your lookup value either. If it is, you'll have to either rearrange your data or you'll have to use a different formula like XLOOKUP. But that's for a future video. Thanks for watching this one. If you liked it, then like it and subscribe so you're up to date with all of our videos. Visit our website for all things tech and software related, and I'll see you next time.